Yes, in this say couple of minutes, we try to explain to you say our project. Let's say our project was called the Copilot Learning Center, and we created this project, of course, for the hackathon, as you know. And especially, we try to explain to you what we did and, of course, how we did. But just for let's say for notice, you we don't go too much deep in the details, in the technical details, because of course of the lack of the time, but we share with you, of course, all the implementation details that we did, of course, and the global perspective of everything. Of course, we need to cover a little bit our approach and technical approach, because at the end we are developers, because as you can see, we are four in the team. If you go to the next slide, Toby, we are four in the team, and all of us are more or less developers. Guido, everyone knows Guido, I think, in this call, and also Toby and Nish. Maybe I'm the only one that no one knows me, because I'm not anymore a little bit in my certified world, because I do something else, but I'm still a developer. And in the next few minutes, we try to explain to you, let's say, our idea, of course, in the first couple of minutes, and then how we did, how we implement, and of course, how also we worked together for this project. Toby, stage is yours.
Thanks, Emma. So let's talk about our idea. Our SharePoint Hackathon 2025 entries a comprehensive Copilot Learning Center. It's more or less a SharePoint communication site designed to help users to learn about Microsoft Copilot and effectively manage AI assistance across their organization. This solution provides organizations with better governance over AI assistance while making Copilot knowledge more accessible to end users. And our initial idea was to build a simple dashboard about Copilot with the goal to bring up all Copilots within your tenant in one dedicated place. Then, after exchanging some thoughts, having fun, and telling some bad jokes, as we always do, we've ended up following the idea to bring a learning center to life. In order to provide meaningful insights into Copilot users or insights to Copilot users, yeah, a learning center that was ready to use, but nevertheless fully customizable along a company's needs. Let's have a closer look at it. This is it. Our Copilot Learning Center. In the current version, it has built on top of out-of-the-box features of SharePoint Online and has been enriched with some open source web parts from the PnP community, as well as some custom code web parts. And this was done on purpose because we wanted to combine the low-code approach by using the platform, the SharePoint platform, and the SharePoint platform's capabilities as well as some community plugins with the pro code approach for some custom SharePoint SPFx web parts that Nish, Guido and me have built. Guido and Nish will tell you more on this shortly. For us, building this stuff was more than only a technical challenge. Besides only writing code that generates some custom SharePoint framework web parts, we also wanted to bring in an educational perspective in the sense of building a place within a company's intranet where employees can find and learn all they want to know from an employee's perspective, all they need to know about Copilot. So let's call our solution a very domain-specific knowledge information system. And of course, we wanted to build it on SharePoint Online, where else? Once again, to get to the point, what started as an initial idea to build something about Copilot is now the realization of an idea of a Copilot Learning Center built or fully built on SharePoint, combining different purposes and integrating several web parts. But now let's start talking about the structure of the site and the building blocks of which our solution consists. Guido, give it a go.
Yes, Toby, can you please return back to the slides so we can all see?
Thank you. Sorry.
No worries. Just so everyone is on the same page. The next one. So yes, let's talk about some quick facts about the technology stack where we developed the tools for that they used custom code. This is all about the SharePoint framework, because we built it with the SharePoint framework version 1.20. We considered using the version 1.21, but it was in beta at the time, and we decided to go for a more stable version instead of the beta one. We also used React and TypeScript for modern UI development. We used the Fluent UI for consistency with Microsoft 365 design language. And we also decided to use the Microsoft 365 APIs for tenant-wide AI file management and retrieval. So going to the next slide, Toby, please. Okay. And here you can see the educational resources. This is a section of our Copilot Learning Center, and it's a curated collection of Microsoft Copilot documentation and training materials. This is powered by the M365 learning pathways. Sixth step to Microsoft Copilot is a comprehensive knowledge base for easy onboarding. And also, we have an embedded video contents from the official Microsoft resources. All the material here was intended to help users to get started with Copilot and also to sharpen the knowledge about it. It's not a completely finished learning resource, as Toby already said. It's more like an entry point to collect according resources at a central place. That's why we choose the M365 learning learning pathways resource. By using this grid content, the learning center can be extended accordingly to every company's needs. And now the mic goes to Nish.
Thanks, thanks, Guido. This section brings the insights in the actual availability of Copilots within your tenant. It means to be a central management interface for all the AI assistants in your tenant, with real-time metrics showing such as total AI files available, and number of Copilots, Copilot files available, and number of SharePoint agents. So we've decided to use PnP Modern Search web parts because they bring in awesome capabilities in information retrieval, as well as huge possibilities of design customization. Otherwise, we would have ended up implementing the whole business logic to handle search queries and process search results. And also because we wanted to do a big shout out to the PnP community. So now back to you, Guido.
Thanks, Nish. Here we have the advanced filtering and search, and the main purpose of this table is meant to aggregate all the available copilots and agents within your tenant at a glance, and allowing users to get insights and details about those alongside a few different operations. The interactive dashboard table, which was built as a custom SharePoint framework web part, displays in the first column the file type indicators, such as the .copilot or .agent files. In the second column, we have the file names, such as the name of the resource. The third column has the creator information. And in the last column, we have the action buttons, such as the folder button to directly open the location of the .copilot or .agent file, as well as the dialog button to start prompting the agent itself. Another capability offered by the table is the toggle on the upper side part, where it's used to switch between viewing all the AI files available or just those created by the current user. There's as well a tab that filters all files by AI type, either Copilot or SharePoint agent files. And then we have the search box in the upper section of the table, which is again powered by the PnP Modern Search and is connected to the custom SharePoint framework web part. This search box allows users to filter the table's result by the inserted text. And now back to Nish.
Perfect. So Yes, Toby, can you go back to the slide, please? No, the one which I'm going to talk is direct interaction. Thank you, perfect. So yes, talking about the action buttons with a little more context here. So we, as Guido said, that by clicking on a respective dialog button from any resource in the table, there's the capability to open any of the AI file just in one click and interact with them directly through a convenient dialog. So the bishop says that this is the way to the way to interact with all AI files within your tenant, right from the Copilot Learning Center. That's pretty cool, isn't it? So next slide, please, again. Thank you. Again, for every resource in the table, there's a capability to show the selected AI file details and instructions. So for this reason, we built another web part. This one takes all the information about the selected AI file. To make the scenario more complicated from a technical point of view, we've decided to implement another web part, which is again connected to the web part that shows the AI file details. Let's call it as summarization web part. Inside the summarization web part, there's a magic button that activates a specialized Copilot that was built in Copilot Studio and have integrated in SPFx component along with single sign-on capability. This is really cool as well, because it's an agent that uses a prompt to prompt another Copilot to summarize the file's purpose, usage guidelines, and to derive practical use cases. A pretty nice setup, right? And now some words to the methodology or about how we work together. Go ahead, Toby.
Thank you very much, Nish. So let's wrap up. As in every project, we had to discuss the way that we work together. Each of us live in a different place. All of us live in Europe, but in different countries, and certain cultural differences could be associated with this. So Guido lives in Italy, where Nish lives in Sweden, and Emanuele and I live in Switzerland. And to be honest, it was our first project of this kind and in this group constellation. Of course, this always bears certain risks. You have to find each other first. You can't predict the team's performance, and you don't know which inner attitudes and paradigms the individual team members stand for. After all, we got to know each other at the last ESPC 24 in Stockholm, which was great. And the tech event quickly formed into a deep friendship. So guys, I have to tell you here, I'm so happy that I've met you there and that the bishop united us in Stockholm. So that's an insider joke, sorry for that. But seriously spoken, we can honestly say that not only one of the challenges I mentioned before occurred. The teamwork worked 100% and we could rely on each other another 100%. Nevertheless, we had to tackle some challenges, as I've told, because we are geographically dispersed and we never worked on a tech-oriented project together, which we all love and which we all do in our daily jobs, but not in these combinations. And these four challenges are worth mentioning. We had to find an idea, what we wanted to implement. And as we told you, there was the star that was given with a search query to get all agents through a tenant. We wanted to offer a place to the users where they can learn more about Copilot and search all the Copilots available in the tenant, because at that time there was no such capability that aggregated all the Copilots dispersed in a tenant in one single place. And we have iteratively and incrementally shaped our initial idea to an implementation plan that really worked. And for a second point, we had to design the solution architecture. That means define structure of the SharePoint site, discuss implementation of the structure of the learning center that came out after the initial discussions. Or we had to deal how to integrate PnP Modern Search in the dashboard and discuss and figure out how to build the so-called magic wand functionality to call the Copilot agent to summarize the agent that you've selected, which Nish was talking about. Then the third place is we had to discuss about the general process to structure our work tasks. We defined to do some Teams calls on a regular basis. So we had to shape out the issues that we wanted to build. So we had to define and write down all those issues and assign them to a responsible within a team. Or there was the implementation discussions that, along the process that we had to transfer every assigned issue into a code representation. Let's say an implementation facing state-of-the-art methods, and we did this by using forks of the dev of the main repository by using common version control system features. We were using Git for this with us, and we had to ensure quality by doing code reviews and as well the integration or manually integration or manually integrating the whole stuff from the fork, from our local forks into the dev branch and then to be merged with the main branch in the main repository. So we called we created pull requests and we worked along those pull requests and those integration flows within the team. And last but not least, we had to give our team a meaningful name, which ended up the Bishop's Teams. Not the Bishop's Team, not Teams. So this is it about our contribution or our submission to the 2025 SharePoint Hackathon. And many thanks to all of you for joining this community call and lending an ear to our story about our Copilot Learning Center, and many thanks also to the organizers for giving us the opportunity to talk about our submission. We're so happy to have been a part of the hackathon, and we, the Bishop's Teams, will definitely be back at the next opportunity. And with that, back to David or Visa. Thank you.